Hello, I'm Cami Emery from the Division of Science, Nursing, and Allied Health at Bossier Parish Community College. What we're going to talk about today in this session of Open Campus is the biological levels of organization. So you've started learning a new language, medical terminology to be specific. You've learned some new words, you're starting to work with those new words. Now let's see what you'll actually be looking at in anatomy and physiology. One of the things we know is that scientists love to organize things and put them in categories to classify those things. So one classification that's used in science is called biological levels of organization. What biological levels of organization basically means is we're going to start at the smallest structure that we can study, and we're going to move up to the most complex. So basically looking at it as moving up the ladder. So let's look at some of these levels and how they relate to A and P, in particular to human anatomy and physiology. The atom is the smallest structure that we can look at. We take atoms, we combine those together, and we form molecules. We put molecules together, and we form macromolecules. Macromolecules are really big molecules. When we combine macromolecules, we form organelles. With a collection of organelles, we form a cell. The organelles help the cell and show the cell how it's going to function. When we take cells and put those together, we form tissues. We put several tissues together and we can form an organ. And of course, if we put organs together, we form an organ system. The organ system that's pictured here is the digestive system. When those 11 different systems are put together, we have the organism that we wish to learn about, which is the human body. So let's look at the smallest thing that we can study and move up from there. So everything, whether it's a living organism or a non-living organism, are made out of elements. The smallest unit of an element is an atom. So this is the smallest structure that can be studied. When we put atoms together, we form molecules. The picture here is a molecule of water. If you look at it, there's two little blue balls, those represent hydrogens, and there's a larger red ball that represents the oxygen. So two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of oxygen, and when those are bonded together, we have a molecule of water. When we write it out chemically, it's H2O. When we take molecules and put those together, we form what's called a macromolecule. Macro, the prefix macro, means big, and this is a big molecule. Some examples of macromolecules are proteins, carbohydrates, fats. This is a drawing of a carbohydrate molecule. What you're actually looking at there, I believe, is a little molecule of glucose, but it's considered a macromolecule. You can see it's made out of carbon, which is represented by the C, hydrogen, which is represented by the H, and oxygen, which is represented by the O. This is a molecule, a macromolecule, because it's big, it's a macromolecule that's a carbohydrate. So let's look at these levels of organization again. We start with the atom, which is the smallest structure that we can study. We take atoms and we combine those together and we form a molecule. This is a molecule of water. One oxygen, two hydrogens, we now have a molecule of water. When we put molecules together, we form macromolecules. Remember, macro means big. Now, if we take those macromolecules and put those together, we form organelles. Organelles are the little structures within a cell that help it to function. So some examples of some organelles are the nucleus, which is typically located in the center of a cell, the mitochondria, which the cell uses to produce energy, the centrioles. We've got endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus. We've got quite a lot of organelles within a cell, but those organelles are going to help the cell to function and allow it to perform the things that are vital for that cell to survive. So when we look at the cell itself, we've taken organelles and put those together. Now we have a cell, basically formed by a collection of organelles. Cells are the simplest structure that are considered to be alive. You look at this diagram of a cell, you can see in the very center, kind of looks like a marble, that's the nucleolus. It's surrounded by a structure called the nucleus. Around the outside of the nucleus is the cytoplasm, and inside of that cytoplasm is a whole bunch of different organelles, ribosomes and endoplasmic reticulum, centrioles, mitochondria, lots of organelles that are going to allow that cell to function as it should. So let's step back again and review our levels of organization. We start with the smallest structure that we can study, which is the atom. We take atoms and put those together and we form molecules. We put molecules together and we form macromolecules. With macromolecules, we put those together and form the organelles. And it's those organelles, when they're put together, that form the cell. Now, if we put cells together, we're going to form tissues. So some of the types of tissues that we can study: connective tissue, epithelial tissue, muscle tissue, and nervous tissue. So the cells come together and they form these types of tissues. When we put tissues together, we form organs. This is a picture of a heart. The heart is an organ. The stomach is an organ. The bladder is an organ. So organs are formed when tissues come together. When we put several organs together and allow them to function together, they form an organ system. The skeletal system is an organ system that's made from the bones. When we put organ systems together, we can create the organism. And like we mentioned before, there's 11 different organisms that allow us to form the human body. So let's look at this level of organization one more time. We start with the atom, which is the smallest structure we can study. We combine atoms together and we form molecules. We put molecules together to form big molecules that are called macromolecules. We put macromolecules together and we can form organelles. The organelle that's pictured here is a mitochondria. When we put organelles together, they form the cell, and the cell is the structure that's going to function for us. The cells together form a tissue. We put tissues together to form an organ. This is the stomach. And the stomach is just one part of an organ system called the digestive system. When we put all 11 of those organ systems together, we form the human organism. I hope this has helped in your understanding of the levels of organization of the human body. Thank you.